Teresa.
The question posed was that will non-Muslims go to heaven and what about Mother Teresa? The reply to this question, who will go to heaven, Jannah, is given in Surah Al-Asr, chapter 103, verse number 1 to 3, which says, Wal-Asr, innal insana lafi khusr, illa allatheena amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr. That by the token of time, man is verily in a state of loss, except those who have faith, those who have righteous deed, those who exhort people to truth, and those who exhort people to patience and perseverance. The minimum criteria is required for any human being to go to Jannah is 4. Have faith, iman, have righteous deed, exhort people to truth, to dawah and Islam, exhort people to patience and perseverance. If any one of these 4 criteria are missing, you shall not enter Jannah. You may be a very good Muslim. You may have performed Hajj, you may be offering Salah, you may have kept fasting month of Ramadan, but if you don't do dawah, you shall not enter Jannah. All 4 criteria are equally important. Iman, righteous deed, exhorting people to truth, dawah and Islam, and exhorting people to patience and perseverance. If anyone is missing, you shall not enter Jannah. So any human being wants to go to Jannah, heaven, you should fulfill all these criteria. Let's take the example of Mother Teresa. You know, we learn and we hear that she got the Nobel Prize and, you know, she has done many good deeds, etc. You know, people have given an award, Nobel Prize. We hear in the newspaper. So maybe you say righteous deed, you know, she gets a high level, righteous deed. You make it high level. Exhorting people to truth, what's the degree? You know, I'm coming from Bombay. I'm an Indian. You know, I have seen many of her organization. And many people can tell you the inside story. There was a person, I think he was a European, from UK, I think, if I'm not mistaken. He wrote a book on Mother Teresa, her inside story. And that book was telling all the negative points that she's the person who has misled so many people, etc. But that Allah knows the best. I leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there are mainly missionary activities they do. They do missionary activities. And how do they help the poor? And the ultimate goal is to convert them to Christianity. I can say because I know I'm living in Bombay and many of our centers are in Bombay. But regarding whether she'll go to heaven or not. See, suppose if you want to pass a school. If you want to pass standard 10, suppose there are 6 subjects. Maths, geography, English, history, science, and whatever it is, there are 6 subjects. And you may score 99 out of 100 in 5. But if you fail in 1, will you pass standard 10? Will you, yes or no? Yes or no? You'll fail. You have to pass in all the 6 subjects. Similarly, to go to Jannah, you should pass in all 4. If anyone is missing, you may get 100 marks in any one particular aspect. I'm not saying that Mother Teresa got 100 marks in righteousness. I'm not telling that. So don't misunderstand me. But surely she didn't have iman. If anyone is missing, you shall not go to Jannah. Even a Muslim who's born in a Muslim family, if he feels he's got the ticket to heaven, it's a misconception. Just by being born in a Muslim family, being called as Muhammad or Zakir or Sultan, you don't get a ticket to heaven. You have to follow all the 4 criteria: iman, righteous deed, exhorting people to truth, exhorting people to patience and perseverance. So any human being, whether it be Mother Teresa, whether it be Sultan, whether it be Muhammad, whether it be Abdullah, whoever it is, or Tom, Dick and Harry, if they fulfill these 4 criteria, inshallah they'll go to Jannah. If anyone is missing, under normal circumstances, they shall not go to Jannah. Hope that answers the question.
Yes, brother.
Islam has fought in the past and present also.